Hi, I'm Susan Duhan Felix. I'm an artist. I've lived in Berkeley since 1967, and I love Berkeley. I have a television program called Bay Area Art Beat. I'm on the Berkeley Cultural Trust, and I am the art ambassador of the city of Berkeley. I'm very, very, very proud of the art scene here. I just think it's fabulous. I think the arts that we have in downtown Berkeley are as good as any place in the world, seriously. There's so many fabulous things going on here. Berkeley Rep is really one of the best theaters in America. We have a wonderful world-class museum. We have fabulous music venue down here. It's an amazing, amazing place to visit. And we have an art festival online. And go to the website of the Downtown Berkeley Association and check it out. And really keep supporting our arts. Do all you can to keep the arts going. This is a hard time for the arts. It's a hard time for artists. It's a hard time for all of us. But really the thing that gives us strength and energy, do what you can to support the arts in Berkeley. You will not be sorry. I'm sending you love.
Hi, I'm Berkeley Mayor Jesse Edegein, and thank you for tuning in to the Downtown Berkeley Online Summer Arts Festival. And thank you for keeping the arts alive in Berkeley. And even though we can't go to the Berkeley Rep or the Freight or the UC Theater in person to see a live performance, thanks to the Downtown Berkeley Association, they're bringing live performances to you. So please continue to tune in, continue to support our arts and cultural organizations in our community, and together we'll get through this difficult time, and hopefully we'll see a show in person someday soon.
Hi, I'm Joanna Felser, Artistic Director of Berkeley Rep. Thank you so much to the Downtown Berkeley Association for inviting Berkeley Rep to participate in the Summer Arts Festival. There has never been a moment that felt more important to gather together and try and keep the arts alive in downtown Berkeley. You know, this moment as the fall begins feels really complicated here at Berkeley Rep. Typically, right now, we would be throwing open the doors of our courtyard and welcoming audiences into the Rota and the Pete's Theater as we begin a season of wonderful plays and musicals. And of course, right now, none of that is possible. But we've been trying to figure out how to stay present for our audiences, even in this moment of shelter in place. So we are going to be streaming throughout the fall work from some of our audience's favorite artists like Hershey Felder and Emma Rice. And at the same time, we're generating brand new pieces to share with you. We're beginning on October 13th with a radio play adaptation of Sinclair Lewis's novel, It Can't Happen Here. Now, many of you will remember that in the fall of 2016, as we approached that election, Berkeley Rep produced the world premiere of a new adaptation of Sinclair Lewis's novel by Tony Taccone and Bennett Cohen, directed by Lisa Peterson. The piece tells the story of a liberal newspaper article who tries to warn his fellow citizens as he watches them begin to elect a demagogue who promises to make America great. And as we look ahead to November 3rd, it feels like an incredibly important moment to remember what our collective power as citizens is, to go out and make sure our voices are heard and vote. So at Berkeley Rep, we're creating this radio play adaptation. We are sharing it with other theaters, universities, community centers across the country. It is a production with many of the original cast members, newly joined for this version by the extraordinary actor and Oscar nominee David Strathairn. So I hope you'll tune in with us on October 13th for that. Also coming up this fall, we are generating a series of audio stories really specific to Berkeley. We've asked 10 different writers with deep roots here in the Bay Area to choose a specific location within the city of Berkeley that's particularly meaningful to them and to craft a story specifically based on their experience of that location. So you'll get a special invitation in the mail. Snail mail, remember that? If you choose to sign up for this series, and you'll be led through the city of Berkeley with 10 different narratives awaiting you at special spots. And of course, we are beginning to prepare for the moment that we can all be back in the theater together. We've got a season of 7 plays and musicals that I can't wait to share with you, from writers including Jocelyn Bio, Dave Malloy, Christina Anderson, the Avett Brothers, Chuck Mee, Martina Myoke, and Lauren Yee. So I really hope you'll subscribe. And as soon as it is safe to do so, we will once again gather together in our theaters and remember that extraordinary experience as these artists can take us through these journeys that remind us of our collective humanity. In the meantime, we have gathered together a series of selections of favorite Berkeley Rep productions from the past 10 years, things that you, our audiences, have particularly loved, artists that are really meaningful to us. So I hope while we wait for the moment that we can all be back in our buildings together, you'll really enjoy these recollections of the fantastic times that we've had in our theaters together in the past. Have fun. I feel love.
We figured out what we want to be called.
The Temptations.
Because once you hear us sing,
you will do anything.
It's not bad, fellas. Let's see what it does.
You know you make me want to shout. Kick my heels up and shout. Throw my hands up and shout. Throw my head back and shout. Come on now.
Shout.
Make it easy.
Shout.
Make it easy.
Shout.
Make it
easy.
They're gonna see 5 gentlemen.
But we'll keep it up and do anything extra, whatever it takes to make a hit.
Hit making isn't easy. Quality controls. My secret weapon at Motown, made up of my department heads and promotion guys, fellas who understand the business. Only artist in quality control is Smokey Robinson. He is our special ace in the hole.
Pleasure to be writing for you, fellas.
I'm gonna run all your songs by quality control, like I do for all my artists.
And what if it don't pass the test?
Then it's back to the drawing board. Only the strongest songs get released.
How you decide if a song is good enough?
If it comes down to spending that last buck on a hot dog or your record, and we wouldn't choose the record, that means it isn't a hit. You have to make people starve over this music.
Spend their last dime on a song? You sure we can do that?
That's why we have Smokey.
I want the love I can see. That's the only kind that means a thing to me. Don't want a love you have to tell me about. That kind of loving I can show to you without. New image. Now follow me. 5, 6, 7, 8. Ba, 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 da, 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 ba, ba. Now your turn. Ba, ba,
Hey, you gotta make the hands flow. Paint the picture.
I don't see no picture.
Paul, I ain't no dancer.
Man, everybody's a dancer. You just gotta find your groove.
Maybe we should keep these moves simple. Don't wanna be tripping all over each other.
Or tripping all over yourself.
That better not be directed at me.
If the two left shoes fit.
Otis, you and me the pretty boys. The ladies don't care about no 5, 6, 7, 8.
We wanna be a hit group. This is what it takes. If you move right, you'll have the ladies eating out the palm of your hands. Smooth hands like on a woman's body, see? Yeah, that's it. Now you put it to the song, and it's magic, baby. I want the love I can feel. That's the only kind of love that I think is real. Don't wanna be broken by something I heard now. Cause baby, actions speak louder than words.
That horizon. Whenever you can, Bowie, try to find the horizon. Things are never as bad as they seem when you can look out to sea. He wasn't always old, you know.
I know.
To me, he's the same as he always was. His eyes are the same. And he doesn't need to speak. Bowie, do you keep a diary?
No, Gran. I don't like writing much.
Oh, Bowie. When I was your age, I kept a diary. I put everything in it. Day-to-day things, secret things. It was company for me, almost like a friend. You should try it.
Okay. Today, I'd write about the Bonneville and Grandad.
Let him go.
Shall we get back to him?
Okay.
Hold tight. Tick, tick. Grumma, grumma, grumma. Oh, supreme, Bowie. Supreme.
Oh, Grandad, you should have seen us. We went the whole way along the beach and then all the way around the village. On the way back, we... Grandad? Grandma?
It's all right. Bowie, it's all right. He's happy now. He's out of it. Out of that ruddy wheelchair. He's free now. We gotta be happy for him. Say our goodbyes and let him go.
Not gone, just gone away.
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 Let him go.
Nothing to be sad about. Folks are hard to live without, but you still got memories to be glad about. Not gone, just gone away.
Let him go.
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 coming. It's a sad day.
She's not saying anything. It's not natural.
Perhaps she's in shock.
She might be in shock, but sooner or later she has to face the fact. Dad is gone.
Give her time. Give her time.
Do you want a crisp, Grandma?
Oh, you know how to spoil a girl.
Well, we can't leave her on her own, we know that.
And she can't keep riding that bloody motorbike. It's a death trap.
I can't face another funeral. I'm going now. This isn't about you.
Ah, isn't it? Well, I know you're all angling for her to come and live with me. That's not going to happen. This is a team responsibility.
She's not mine, Mother.
Martin!
What did I do now? Would you like a wasabi nut?
Oh, yeah.
One?
Yeah.
Wasabi nuts? Let's try and stay on message here, Marge. What about Mum?
They keep looking at us funny.
We'll look funny back.
Oh, my God, here we go. Lost it.
Are you okay?
You don't have to worry about me, dear. I've got notions. You have to have notions.
Notions? What notions?
Bowie, I'm going away for a while.
Why?
I'm leaving heaven to you now. I'll take my illness with me, and I'll take my death with me, too. The earth's my home, and I want to go home. Before I depart,
A homecoming gift.
What?
I can't read the label.
My eyes. They aren't any better.
ACT?
What? How on earth? These are hot pills. I'm shocked.
A contribution to the Get Well Fund from a bad fairy.
These pills, they make you better. They're poison. They make you anemic. This is my life from now on, Lewis. I'm not getting better. I'm not sure I'm ready to do that to my bone marrow yet.
We can talk about it tomorrow. I'm going home to nurse my grudges. Ta, baby. Sleep all day. Ta, Lewis. You really know how to clear a room.
His body is shutting down. Do you understand? He can barely sip water. Okay. He's not going to eat this. He can't.
Soup.
All right, make it. What does it matter?
He's asking why you cook so well, where it came from.
I don't know. I mean, I had to cook. I mean, come on, Dad. He didn't even know how to make rice.
니네 할머니 손맛이야.
Oh, it's your grandmother's 손맛.
할머니 손맛.
Like her tasty hands.
What?
아니, 들어봐라. 우리 어머니 요리 하나로 사방 꼭꼭 천지까지 소문났던 분이다. 우리 어머니 김치는 전설이요. 설렁탕은 시조예요. 고등어 무조림이 노래요. 심지어 밥, 쌀밥조차도 한 톨 한 톨 완벽했어. 난 다 먹어 즐기 바빴는데 병님은 애초부터 본대만대 했다. 뭔 맛인지 어디서 왔는지 누가 했는지 상관 안 했어. 한 번은 다 썩어 고린내나는 고기 조각을 집어먹는데 씹으면서도 그게 썩었나 아닌가를 모르더라니까. 어머니 마음 많이 상했지. 5만 사람들이 당신 밥이 최고다 하면 뭐하나? 아들 자식은 관심도 없는데. 형은 깡마리고 난 토실토실하고 형은 서름서름하고 난 길 가는 개한테도 정 주고. 그래도 어머니는 형을 더 그게 사이를 벌어지게 했나 몰라. 그래서 별로 친하지 못하는지도.
When the tear gas, it make the sun eclipse. The birds go crazy like it's a bad sign. The children, they are terrified. I'm thinking, I'm going to die right there for sure. My daughter, she's gonna die with me right there for sure.
How old's your daughter?
7 years, man.
What's her name?
I cannot snitch on her, man.
What happened next?
The blue van take us to the dark side of the mountain.
The Mexican side?
Correcto.
Near Eagle Pass, Texas.
Piedras Negras. There we meet a new coyote. He lied to us right away, man. He say, hey, guys, run through the next mountain. There is water there, you know. Run through the next mountain. There is shelter. But my daughter, she cannot run so well in the mountains, so I have no choice. Walk to the U.S. border fence, and there we surrender.
To the ICE detention center.
Si, senor, but there were too many people in this sector, un chingo de gente, so they bring us to here.
Welcome to the refrigeration units of West County.
Welcome to Contra Costa.
So fucking cold here, I could never imagine.
Keep talking, Deportee.
I have a cousin, he lives in Northern California, in San Leandro. You ever hear of this horrifying place?
Yeah.
He have a house there. He say I can chill in his garage. But then he fall in love with a very large, toothless, tweaker, blonde woman, and he lose his house. And now he sleep in the parking lot in Home Depot in Oakland.
What kind of work do you think you can get here?
Wendell, you know of this Oakland Bay Bridge?
Never heard of it.
Well, my cousin, he was years ago the maintenance guy there. He still have the connections. He gonna hook it up for me. And he was the guy who changed all the light bulbs across the bridge. You know, thousands of light bulbs, but he can no longer do this because he get the carpal tunnel syndrome, okay? He's the first Mexican in history to get the carpal tunnel. I hope one day to have this gringo malady.
Bad news, the bridge switched to solar.
No, no me digas, no more this.
You can thank Governor Newsom for taking your job.
Why Gavin need my job? He's so good looking, that is. It don't matter, man. I'm gonna move to the Mission District.
The Mission don't want more Mexicans.
You'll get run over by a millennial on a scooter.
No matter, guys. I joined the gig economy. I do Grubhub. I make the money somehow. I get my daughter and we move to beautiful San Francisco.
If we can't afford the Bay Area, neither can you, pal.
Yeah, I live in Antioch. He lives in Vacaville.
Those towns sound horrible to me. No matter, guys. I'll do it. I'm not afraid to work. I'm not a Korean parasite, okay? I even tell the Border Patrol guys I will help Donald Trump build his pinche wall.
You're gonna help Trump build his wall?
A Mexican do the job as good as anybody, con calma, si permites. Why, a Mexican will do a beautiful job. A very professional wall we will build. Very aesthetically pleasing to the eyes, you know? Like an Aztec engineer. The wind will not knock over my wall, no senor. We will paint monarch butterflies on the side of the wall, you know, like a Frida Kahlo mural. But the Mexicans are gonna know where the secret tunnels are so that we can sneak back in.
A todo dar.
Like El Chapo.
El Chapo, this guy funny, man.
Does El Chapo mean something special to you, pal?
Yeah. No, he's the guy that say El Chapo, man. I hate El Chapo. He's a killer, man. No, I see what's happening here. You guys not appreciating my Trump wall humor. My bad. Do not snitch on me. You guys are very professional. I have nothing but respect for you ICE agents. We're not ICE agents.
What'd you say?
We're not ICE agents.
We work in theater. We gather stories.
We just interviewed a couple of ICE agents.
They gave us this swag.
What the fuck? This is very bad fucking news!
So we're actors?
That we're theater folk?
No, that I'm thinking I'm making some relationship, establishing rapport with two ICE agent vatos, you know? Like, we're gonna hang out or something. You're gonna take me to IKEA for Swedish meatballs or something like this. This is a false narrative.
No, this is a conversation for the American stage.
American stage?
We create safe story circles.
What a fucking waste of time. This is a game to you guys.
Nonprofit theater is no game.
Do you have a pronoun preference?
I'm so fucking confused right now. I do not know what's happening in this moment. This is a jailhouse interrogation or I am your fucking research?
Both!
I am seeking asylum or I am an American invader?
Both!
I am time-honored refugee arriving on your teeming shore or I am dog fucker?
Dog fucker.
America, she have two souls.
Write that down.
Sweet. But no matter. I show America that I be good citizen one day. I be great American like
Colin Powell?
Nancy Pelosi.
Oh. Why her?
She ride with Pancho Villa.
She's not that old.
You bought the root vegetables I asked you to, didn't you? Dayton? Dayton! How come he can hear me when I'm not even talking to him, but the second I ask him for something, he can't hear a thing? Oh, company's here and I'm not ready. Oh, I haven't even started the root vegetables and they need at least an hour. Oh, no. Dayton! Oh, I have more. Oh, Dayton! What did I say about putting beer on my coffee table? Oh, like he doesn't care what we look like to people. Dayton! Dayton, where's the cheese plate? Oh, Lord, give me strength. Dayton! Dayton! Dayton!
I'll answer the door. You finish up in the kitchen.
I just want everything to go well today.
Oh, everything will be fine. Don't worry.
Hey! How you doing, baby?
I'm fine, Jasmine.
Are you?
Yes, I'm doing well.
That's not what I heard.
Can I take that wine from you? Oh, hey, why don't you help yourself to some cheese? We have an aged Gouda, a humble fog, and some lovely brie.
Oh, wow. I'm off dairy. That looks nice, though, doesn't it?
I didn't know that.
Can't you tell? I think I look like a snack.
Does Beverly know that?
Well, if my sister cared to know, then she would know.
All right, Jasmine. Can I get you a glass of wine?
I want the wine I brought. I'll wait.
What?
It's a special day. I'm here for Mom's birthday, She was a wonderful mother to you and me and Tyrone. She has lived a long, illustrious life. And I'm not trying to disrespect that because you're tripping over some budget brie and some grapes.
Jasmine.
Oh, come on, girl. You out here with some President Brie ain't cost more than $3.99 talking about special cheese for mama.
Please don't start with me tonight.
I didn't start anything. You're the one who summons us all to your house like you the Queen of Sheba. You're the one who walked in. No hello. No how are you. Just on me right away about some $3.99 cheese. Well, I might feel some type of way about that. That's all I'm saying.
Today isn't about you, and it isn't about me. It's about Mama.
I know exactly what today is about. Is she here?
She's upstairs.
Well, let me go up and say hello.
No, Jasmine, don't.
Why are you so nervous?
I'm not nervous.
What is there to be nervous about?
Nothing. I just want everything to go well today.
It will.
It has to, Jasmine. It just has to.
Beverly, you're going to give yourself a stroke if you don't calm down. Sit down. Have a glass of wine. I brought rosé.
That does sound nice.
It's from France.
Well, I just put it in the fridge. Do you want a glass?
Well, put an ice cube in it since it's still warm.
All right, Jasmine. All right.
You don't have to take a tone with me after you get me all stressed. And put the rest of the bottle in the freezer so it gets cold. You hear that, Beverly? Beverly! Damn! That woman never listens to anybody. Hi, Jessica! Keisha! You startled me!
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's all right.
Well, practice ran over again because Tanya was late again. So Coach made everyone run a lap for every minute she was late, but she was a full 17 minutes late. So everyone had to run 17 laps after practice just because Tanya is obsessed with Jaden.
That's right. That's right. We gave you all potatoes, tomatoes, and chocolate. You're welcome. And we also gave you tons of gold. Because we had some beautiful, beautiful museum-type golden artifacts until the, okay, time out. Historic footnote, people. Historic footnote time. Why is all our art called folk art and all of European art is called fine art and then modern art is just our folk art gentrified? You, sir. I got to give you a second chance, right?
Sure.
Sure what?
Yes, sir.
What's the answer? 1.3 million. Ah, sorry, you're not paying attention. That's two. We're getting dangerously close to be thrown out of my class. Now, for the rest of you who are paying attention, because los conquistadores come mierda y hueputa mama huevo, melted all our golden folk art into coins. Yo, that's like going to the Museum of Florence and seeing the statue of David and going, Larry, look at that statue. It would make a lovely marble kitchen counter. Because King Philip of Spain took 500,000 tons of gold from us by dismissing us as pagan savages. Yeah, I got your savage right here, buddy. And 500,000 tons is 1 billion pounds of gold. Just picture Run DMC with 1 billion gold chains. All right? And that melted gold also funded the British, French, and Ottoman empires of the 1600s. And this King Philip of Spain was a disgusting, greedy son of a bitch. And he was always, felicitaciones, conquistadores. You're doing God's work by robbing and killing and raping, robbing and killing and robbing and raping and robbing and killing and robbing and raping. Okay, now, first order of business, you conquistadores can keep a whole 100% of half. But Your Majesty, you can't have three halves of a whole. Thank you. Kill him, Inquisition! He's a witch! Kill him! Ah, no! Ah, no! Oh, robbing and raping and robbing and raping and... So, yo, I had just started all my research, man, and I was finding all these historic bullies, and I was digging all the research, right? When my wife comes in all verklempt, and she's like, John, I just talked to Buddy's history teacher. And Buddy's got a year-long heroes project that he's just falling behind on. Can you talk to him? Because I'm already overloaded with Boo. Well, why can't I help Boo with her homework? Okay, John, you help her with the trigonometry. Okay, I'll help Buddy. Just as I suspected, John. And you know, he's in a really fragile place. Can you just get on it and please don't mess it up? Don't worry, honey. Don't worry. I'm fucking things up as fast as I can, okay? All right? Okay, I'm going. I'm going. I'm just kidding, all right? I got this. I got it. I got it. So I wait for her to leave, and then I take the opportunity to coach my son. I'm like, Buddy, look, if that bully comes up to you again and says to you, I come from a long line of blah, 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 whatever, you tell him, it doesn't matter because we were here first. But, Dad, what if that doesn't work, Dad? Well, then... sucker punch him, man. But Dad, Gandhi said that if we all took an eye for an eye, we would all be blind, Dad. Oh, come on, honey. Gandhi couldn't think straight because he was always hungry. All right, we good? You got your marching orders? Okay, go. But Dad, we didn't even go over the history homework, Dad. I don't have any other names besides Columbus. Oh, honey, you got this. You worry too much. You're like your mom. Come on, you go play. Go. But maybe I did rush my son a little too much because the poor guy goes up in his history class and he's all like, besides Columbus, I know we had a lot of other Latin heroes, but I'm just working on getting the rest of the names and dates when I get them. And the bully corners me after class. He's like, that's because there are no other Latin heroes. So why don't you go back to where you came from, dickfish? Shut up. I don't have to go anywhere because we were here first. Oh, yeah? Yeah, you got any facts to prove it? Well, I never said that I was perfect with the facts. Oh, you're damn straight you're not perfect. Look at him, the king of not perfection, you little bitch. Yeah, cry. Run crying home, you little not perfect king bitch motherfucker. And my son comes running home, and he runs up to his room and locks himself up in the room. And so I go up there, put on my best dad hat, and I say to him, honey, I'm sorry, but life is going to fuck you sometimes, man. And you just got to, keep changing positions until it feels good somehow.
Please approach the podium. Your time begins now.
The Constitution is a living document. That is what is so beautiful about it. It is a living, warm-blooded, steamy document. It is not a patchwork quilt. It is hot and sweaty. It is a crucible. Do you know what a crucible is? It is a pot in which you put many different ingredients and then you boil them up together until they become something else. Something that is sometimes magic. So you see, the Constitution is like a witch's cauldron. Now, you all know so much more about the Constitution than I do because you have all fought in wars. Thank you. Thank you for fighting for our country and also for giving me so much scholarship money. Looking at all of you reminds me of a fantasy I used to have as a little girl about being attacked by a rapist or murderer. A rapist or murderer who's a man, like all of you. In my fantasy, I am able to talk the rapist and murderer out of murdering me because I am able to make you see that just like you, I am a human being. You say, I'm here to murder you, and I say, no, think about this for a moment. Just like you, I am a human being. And then you see me for the first time as a human being. You say, oh my God, you're right, you are a human being. And then you start to cry, and I forgive you, and a rainbow appears. And we climb up on this rainbow together, and by this time, a big crowd of my friends from school has gathered on the street below, and they are so jealous to see me walking on this rainbow. Doesn't she have to be in school? How can she be so special? And I'm like, I'm delivering this poor man to heaven. Have a good time in PE. How does this relate to the crucible of the Constitution? Well, you see, a crucible is a witch's cauldron. That is one definition. But a crucible is also a severe test of patience or belief. A severe test such as the one you and I went through together when you wanted to murder me. Just like with our situation, the Constitution can be thought of as a boiling pot in which we are thrown together in sizzling and steamy conflict to find out what it is we truly believe. This is why it's such a radical document. 202 years ago, a group of magicians got together on a sweltering summer day in Philadelphia, and they wanted to kill each other, but instead, they sat down together and they performed a collective act of ethical visualization. Or as I like to call it, a spell. Now, did they get everything right? No. But that's what amendments are for, right? Which is why, to conclude my speech, I would like to talk about the most mysterious and magical amendment of them all, Amendment 9. Amendment 9 says, the enumeration in the Constitution of certain rights shall not be construed to deny or disparage others retained by the people. This means, just because the Constitution doesn't list a certain right, it doesn't mean you don't have that right. The fact is, the framers couldn't possibly put down all the rights that we have. I mean, the right to brush your teeth. Yes, you've got it. But how long do we want this document to be? Here's another example. When I was a kid, I used to have an imaginary friend named Reba McEntire. She was not related to the singer. Just because the Constitution does not proclaim the having of imaginary friends as one of my rights does not mean I can be persecuted for being friends with Reba McEntire. Isn't that amazing? Think about this for a moment. The Constitution doesn't tell you all the rights that you have because it doesn't know. Justice William O. Douglas, when he talked about this amendment, he used the word penumbra. What is a penumbra? Well, here I am standing in the light, and there you are, sitting in the darkness, and this space between us, this space of partial illumination, this is a penumbra. People laughed at Douglas for calling it this, but I like it. I think this is a helpful way to think about the Constitution and also maybe about our lives. I mean, here we are, stuck between what we can see and what we can't. We are trapped in a penumbra. It's like how when I was a kid, I used to believe I was a changeling. I mean, I still think that might be true, but I'm going to go ahead and keep acting like a human being because what is the alternative?
Where is she? If there's a wanted sign of her posted around town, then she must be close by. Where is she, Rev?
Thank God some friends with the underground found her last week down near the river. She's been staying with them, uptown. She is safe.
You gotta let me see her.
There is going to be a protest uptown, Will Henry. It's too dangerous. Is this gal really worth you putting both your lives in danger?
On the Tennessee plantation, that's where I was born. Used to be the whole creation, hoeing in the corn. Oh, how I'd work and sweat, my body busting every day, till Angelina Baker came and stole my heart away. Angelina Baker, smiling like the sun, the face I dreamed of every day until my work was done. Angelina Baker, she is always on my mind. Sometimes to escape the worst, you leave the best behind. All the years that I've been slaving, working on the land, till I was brave enough to ask the master for her hand. Well, master laughed and stripped me bare, his wind drawn in a flash. But all I saw was Angelina's face between every lash. She was smiling like the sun. Angelina held my gaze till master work was done. Angelina Baker, the face that rescued me. I swear, my dear, I'll get you here. Come and marry me. She saved me, Rev. The master was going to sell me, so she killed him, and we both got away. She the reason I'm free.
You leave at your own risk.
I swear, my dear, I'll get you here. Come and marry me.
Yes. Water.
Fridge or tap?
Fridge or tap.
Your water. Fridge or tap?
Fridge. Thank you. My...
Myself. Parvatlal Kanhaiyalal Dube. Event planner. Your good name, madam?
Eh? Elis.
Hey. Liz. Hey. Liz. Hey.
Abe Dube. Is this your oldest gold generator? I am going to fire you.
Tension not, sir. God is there, no. He'll take care of everything.
Abe Chube. Have you arranged for the waterproofing at least?
Waterproofing? But there was no discussion of that.
What did you think emergency plans meant? Handing umbrellas to guests? It's the bloody monsoon season.
The peacocks have stopped dancing, sir. There will be no rain.
Are you on drugs, Dube? Eh? Chutiye kaam chor, get it done now.
Done, 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 sir.
Oh, gore, gore, oh, baki chore. Kabhi meri gali aaya karo. Chori, chahe roz bulaya karo. Oh, gori, gori, oh, baki chori, kabhi meri gali aaya karo. Oh, gori, gori,
better give me fair and lovely grandchildren, huh?
Not funny.
Don't make fun of your elders, Rhea.
M.I.T. M.I.T.
Will you all please just stop?
Arey, Chachu. Surprise!
Tej Praji.
Oh, Tej
Praji. Vijaya, my darling sister, you're here.
Of course we are here. How could I miss my niece's wedding?
But how did you get here from the airport?
We took a cab.
You took a cab?
Shit. Cabs are best.
Beta.
You useless idiot duffer. One thing I asked you to do. One thing only. Pick up the guest from the airport.
Enough, Lalith. He's not a kid anymore.
You're right, Tej Praji, but then he should also act like a man, no? And help his father.
Varun, yes. Beta, take the bags up. Alice, heat up dinner.
Teji, you're looking very fit, fat.
Arre, California makes everyone look fit, fat.
Nothing like that. Just fruits, vegetables, daily yoga.
Daily yoga? Huh? You become such an American?
And Shashi, look at you.
Thanks.
Hello, Rhea.
Hello.
My good girl. You've become even more beautiful in the last 5 years.
Come on, please eat. You must be so hungry after your long flight.
Only 4 things? Is this a wedding home or a birthday party? Pimmi, I'll organize dinner. Chalo. Chalo!
Now that you're here, yes. Tej Bhai Sab, you put some sense into Rhea's head. She wants to go study writing in America. Writing!
Arre, Pimmi. Engineering, medicine, those were our choices. But the world is different now. We should encourage our children to follow their dreams.
But America? How will we? How can we afford?
Not to worry. After I've paid off this wedding, I'll find a way for my darling Rhea.
Now I'm here. There's no need to worry about anything. If Rhea wants to study in America, I will fund her entire education. No arguments from you or from anyone. This is my right as the head of this family.
Rhea, aren't you going to say thank you to Tej uncle?
You don't thank family.
You've always done so much for us, Tej Praji. Your whole family has. You know, CL, when my parents came with nothing from Lahore after the partition, it was Tej Praji's father who took them in. We owe them our lives.
Lallu, look what I found when we moved last month. You remember this picture of Surinder Bhai Sahab? Huh?
Oh, our dear brother. Rhea, look. Your papa.
Seeing those artists again reminds me of these amazing moments at the Rep. And for me, some of my favorite times in those moments were also when we were filled with teens and young people who were experiencing theater for their first time. And though we've missed having so many of you in our buildings, we are excited for the ways that we have gotten to connect over the last couple of seasons, right? The end of the winter, the spring, the summer. We've still had young people and emerging artists and seasoned professionals finding their ways into our classes to try out something new or to engage more deeply in what they've done. Each class of that, I've been surprised, I guess amazed by not only the generosity of our faculty who've jumped into an unknown with verve and ingenuity, but also with each of the students who have used this moment to connect deeply, creatively, and with a compassion for each of the other students' lived experiences in this virtual space that reminds me that we will find human moments in this kind of isolated experience we're all going through. If, for instance, our Teen 1X Festival started rehearsals in person, actually moved online, and was able to finish out most of their process online so that they could present 3 short plays as a film, as films that you can actually still see a teaser of on our website. So we were still able to conduct our 1X Festival, partly because these amazing teenagers, directors, designers, playwrights, people you need to watch out for, because in the future, as well as today already making just amazing commentary on how we function in this space, on what stories are important to tell, on how to keep people included, continues to inspire us, our staff, to just dig deep and find other ways to connect with all of you as we keep moving in to this time of social distancing and looking out for each other. So this fall, a couple things I want you to look out for. We are presenting a deep dive series, Furthering Your Craft with Berkeley Rep's Artistic Innovators. And that's gonna include some of your favorite Berkeley Rep artists teaching an in-depth 3-hour workshop that you can be a part of. And what I'm most excited about this is we've actually saved a few spots for emerging artists to be able to be in the space. We know so many of our artists are operating on a much less income or no income at all. And so we're trying to figure out how to make space for all of you in those classes. So look out for that, which is out in the world today. And then the other thing I want everyone to know is that our fall classes are on sale. So if you are ready to try something new, come join us at the Rep online for now and connect with some other people and remind yourself of that moment where you discover something new about yourself in this experience. Look out if you're a school teacher, and thank you so much for the heavy lift that you're doing if you are. We all know what crazy changing times these are for those of our friends in the public education system and in all of our school systems. So we've got a couple of shows coming up in the fall that we want you to keep your eyes peeled for, because we're gonna have special student access to them, as well as all sorts of materials to engage your classroom around those discussions. So lots of things happening this fall at the Rep, and I hope you'll make time to connect with us, to engage in something ambitious, to discover something new, and to connect with a little bit of compassion.
Thanks again to the Downtown Berkeley Association for including us. Hope to see you all soon in person.
Hello, everybody. This is Renee Mandel, Artistic Director of Berkeley Symphony. Thank you very much for your support and for keeping the arts alive in downtown Berkeley. Mwah.